Hi guys, it's Tana Mongeau, and I never sit down to film story times like right after they happen pretty much. I always kind of let them like simmer, you know what I mean? Especially if something's like hectic or like it makes me mad. I try to just kind of like let it simmer, think about how I want to tell the story, try not to expose anybody's names and think it through, but that doesn't always happen. Shout out to my Disney Star story, I'm a fucking piece of shit. But this literally just happened to me like an hour ago, and I was totally just gonna make it like a Snapchat story video or like a vlog channel excerpt type thing. And then more and more bad shit kept happening. And finally I was like, fuck it, I'm just gonna make a story time for my main channel. Because what the fuck? I literally cannot go out to a party and just have a good time with my friends ever without anything bad happening to me, and it is so frustrating. Like, Tana, do you want to go out and be a normal teenager and have a really good time because you work hard and when you have time off, you deserve it? Or do you want to live until you're 30 because you have to fucking pick one unlike the rest of the world? So I'm just gonna hop right in, but before I do, please make sure to subscribe while I'm still alive. The more that I say things like that, it's just going up in like the belief of that being true. Like, I'm not gonna live to 80. Like, I'm not gonna live to 70. I'm not gonna die of like dementia. Like, I'm gonna die because someone's gonna fucking kill me or something's gonna fucking kill me. Welcome to my channel. So tonight I went out with my friends to what everyone was telling me was gonna be a kickback. And that's like pretty much, especially in Vegas, only what I go out to anymore is like kickbacks with like 15 friends so that I can just hang out and have a good time. I'm not worried about dying, but that wasn't tonight. So everyone told me it was gonna be a kickback, and I show up and it is like 100% a house party. But I know most of the people there, and I was having like a good time. I was like, you know, I might as well just stay. Like, who cares if it's a house party? It's not that big of a deal. Like, you got ready literally in party clothes, like wearing floral high-waisted shorts, just got the fuck home, bitch. Yeah. And so obviously when I tell party stories, a lot of the time there's alcohol there. I don't drink, especially in settings like this, because I just feel like bad shit already happens to me, and then trying to like balance that with being like intoxicated is just a really unintelligent decision, and I've learned that over the years. So I'm always the babysitter, the mom, the like, why aren't you drinking? Like, you're like such a grandma now that you do YouTube. But I'm like, nah, I'm just trying to live, you know? Like, like, you bitches can do 8 shots and like not die. And I don't mean die of like getting too drunk. I mean like no one tries to like kill you. And I can't do that. But everyone there, pretty much, other than like me and the people I came with, were like fucked up. But I was still having a good time because like drunk girls are so funny. Like, your hair, I love it. And then all of a sudden I noticed this guy, and you know me, I always get weird vibes right away. And he's like walking around the party with a big bottle of New Amsterdam. And it's like regular original New Amsterdam, which if you've ever tried any kind of alcohol, especially vodka, that's just original flavored, bitch, that shit tastes like nail polish remover. And he's walking around to like groups of girls being like, this is so good, like just try it. My first thing to say to someone, like the first time I heard him say that, is like, this dude is really trying to fucking tell people it's so good. Like, bitch, if I drank Sally Hansen nail polish remover, it would probably taste better than that alcohol. So for you to be like, this good, is like so fucking stupid. And the fact that girls are like, oh, okay, like glug 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 glug, blows my mind, because if someone said that to me, I would be like, at least we like have a drink, not like this is good, like you're lying, like why? And so because he was already giving me bad vibes, and I was like, this dude's weird, like why is he saying that to people, I start watching him, and I notice that he's not drinking the alcohol himself, and then he's just walking around to like groups of girls basically saying like, this is good, try this. And then when they're like no, he's like pushing it on them, either being like, drink it, like no, it's really good, or like, just take a shot, like what are you, a pussy, like blah blah blah. And that's literally number 2 red flag, like this guy is trying to roofie them. Number 3 even, because he's not drinking it, I like, I'm like, whatever, okay, it's not that it's like not my problem and like that I don't feel bad, but I've learned that being like Captain Save-A-Ho at parties like that never puts me in a good situation, and that guy will like yell at me or like fucking like hit me with over the head with the bottle, like something, nothing good ever happens to me when I step into bad situations. So I've kind of had to just learn to like bite my tongue because I don't want to die. So I move on and I stop thinking about it, and then I start to notice that like girls were like taking like 1 or 2 big swallows of it, and then 15 minutes later were like ridiculously drunker than they were before. The kind of drunk that it would normally take you to drink like 20 shots of, blackout, like can't walk, like falling all over the floor, like you know what I mean, like dropping their shit everywhere, like can't talk. And that doesn't happen from 1 or 2 swallows, and maybe that does happen to small people or like lightweights, but to be happening to like several girls. So then I'm standing with like Bella, and the guy walks over to me and Bella, and I'm standing with a few other of my friends, but I'm obviously not gonna say their name. So he walks over and he's like, hey, you guys should drink this. And I'm not listening to him while he's saying this, so one of my friends starts to take a drink of it. So I'm like, no, don't drink that. And then everyone's like, why? And I'm like, oh, I'll just hold it. Like, I pretend like I want it because I didn't, like, the guy was like, obviously, like, what the fuck? And then so he was like, okay, why don't you take a drink of it then? And I was like, Fuck. Mr. Krabs meme. Didn't think this through at all. So I'm holding this giant fucking handle of New Amsterdam and I'm like, no. So I'm like, no, I don't want to. And he's like, why? And I'm like, I don't want to. I'm just not drinking tonight. And he's like, seriously, it's good. Just try it. And I'm like, you're honestly sitting here trying to tell me New Amsterdam is good. Like original. Like it's not flavored. Like it's not blueberry. Like original. Like rubbing alcohol. And he's like, just take a drink of it. And I'm like, you know what, dude? I wasn't going to say anything. And I might just be like a completely crazy paranoid ass bitch. And I really hope you don't get offended. But like, it's really obvious that you're like trying to roofie me. And he was like he was like shook. He was woke. He was taken the fuck aback. Like, I don't think this guy expected a bitch to like say that to him because his face was priceless. Like, da, da, da. Like, what the fuck? This bitch like shook. I shook this motherfucker. And keep in mind, this guy is also like 6'4", like buff as fuck. And like walking around like alone, like it was scary. I shouldn't have said it, but like I just say what's on my mind. And he was like, and he looks at me and I'm expecting him to laugh and be like, no, I'm not. And he goes like this. He goes, like, oh shit, you're right. Like, this bitch smart. Like, okay, okay, you're right. And he takes the bottle and walks away. And then walks over to another group of people. And I'm like, dude, okay, if you guys watch my channel and you are not new to this channel at all, because everything bad in the world happens to me, I'm the most paranoid bitch you will ever meet in life. Like, if someone puts their hand in their pocket, I think it's a gun. If I hear a firework, I duck to the ground because I think it's a gun. If someone gives me gum, if an Uber driver hands me gum, it's acid. Like, it's acid and he wants me to trip balls. If someone gives me water, it's Molly water. If a random person puts their hand on me, they're about to fight me. If people knock on the door of a party, it's a cop. If anyone starts fighting anywhere, there's a gun. We'll get into that in a moment. But I'm just the most paranoid human being ever to a really, really high extent. All my close friends, if you're close with me, they hate it because I'm so, so paranoid. Like, you guys have no idea. Just from the amount I tell you on my channel, it's 1,000 times worse. I think every situation's sketchy. A lot of times I'm right about sketchy situations, but I always think people are trying to roofie me and they're not. Like, literally waiters at restaurants, I'll be like, they roofied this lasagna. It's that bad. Like, it really is 100% that bad. Like, I'll be getting my hair dyed by like a new person, not my hair lady, you the real MVP, and be like, they're putting drugs in this like on my head and it's gonna seep in through my scalp and I'm gonna die and overdose on Molly. I'm the most paranoid person you'll ever meet. So for paranoid Tana to be 100% right in a really honestly far-fetched situation, I guess guys trying to roofie girls at parties isn't that far-fetched. It's actually really, really common. Don't put your drink down. Don't drink out of drinks that people don't know. And if a guy's trying to offer you fucking rubbing alcohol telling you it's good, don't drink it. For me to be feasibly right was such an ego boost. I was fucking sucking my own cock for like 30 seconds because paranoid Tana is never right. It felt kind of good that like I did some good. Like, I saved a girl's life. So then I go over to a bunch of my guy friends and I'm telling them what's happening. And they're like, Tana, you're just being paranoid Tana. Like, he's not trying to do that. Like, maybe he was just like, I'll give it to someone else. This bitch is crazy. He's probably not trying to do that. Whatever. So then we all start watching him and he's still trying to give it to other groups of girls. Guys will never drink out of a roofied bottle. Like, if they're trying to roofie girls, they're not gonna drink out of it. They don't wanna get roofied, you know what I mean? So, like, if he doesn't ever drink out of the bottle, then that's a bigger indicator that he is trying to roofie someone, you know what I mean? So one of my guy friends calls him over and they're like, hey, yo, dude, can I have a sip of that? And he's like, nah, nah, fam, this is mine. And then they're like, okay, if it's yours, why don't you take a sip of it? And he's like, nah, dude. And they're like, why? Like, you're telling everyone it's good as fuck. Like, why don't you take a sip? And he's like, for sure, for sure. And then he just holds the bottle and starts dancing away to the music, like hitting the dab and shit. Not taking a drink out of the bottle at all, just dances away and then continues trying to give it to other girls. And then everyone around me was like, shit. And then all these girls are coming up to me now being like, what do? I drink out of the bottle. Like, oh my God, what do we do? And I'm like, I'm not Mother Teresa. I don't know what to do. Drink water, like go throw up, like call your mom. Like, I don't, because it's not like I know what to do in that situation. I just know not to drink out of things like that. You know what I mean? I just have sketch vibes about the whole party. I just want to leave. I want to go home. Like 20 minutes later after the party goes on, the guy kind of disappears. I can't find him anywhere, whatever. One of my really close guy friends comes inside and he's like, you'll never guess what just happened. And I'm like, what? And I'm like, definitely not expecting what he's about to say. And he's like, I was just outside and this random guy walks up to me and he like pushes me and he's like, you trying to fight? And I'm like, no, I don't want to fight you. Like, what the fuck? I don't even know you, dude. Like, do you have a problem with me? Like, what's good? And then my guy friend was like, I'm not trying to fight you at all, but like, if you're just like trying to fight me, like, what's good, you know? And then the guy takes out a gun, puts it to his chest and is like, but are you strapped though? And then my guy friend's like, nah, nah, it's not like that. Like, I'm not trying to like gun fight you. Like, what the fuck? I don't even know you. What's your problem? And the dude's like, don't fuck with me. And then takes the gun and shoots it in the air like 2 times and then just leaves, like leaves the party. And that's like it. So my guy friend comes inside and tells me all of this. And I immediately am like, okay, I just want to leave. I don't give a fuck. I didn't hear the gunshot, but the music inside of the party was really, really loud. So I'm assuming that's why. This could all just be like supposed at this point, you know, and that's why it wasn't like story time for me. But we'll get into why it is, okay? So then I'm freaking the fuck out. I'm like, I wanna leave, I wanna leave, I wanna leave. So I'm telling all my friends, like, can we fucking go? I wanna leave. And everyone's like, all the girls that are like dying because they're reviewed, like, what if it's a fight?
firework. I thought it was a firework. And I'm like,
this person, this credible human being, like he's not alive, came inside and was like, this guy just held a gun to me and shot it in the air. And you're really gonna sit here and be like, what if it's a firework? People like you die. Like scary movies, you die. And so I'm like, I'm not gonna go through the front yard because that guy could very well just be like right there. I don't wanna walk out the front door. Like, what the fuck? And so I start to walk out the back door of the party. And of course, this house is like higher up on the street than all of the other houses. So to hop any of the walls to get out of the house, you would be hopping like a 15-foot drop because I was totally just gonna jump into the neighbor's backyard and go out there fucking through their gate and through their front door, which I know is so ballsy, but I'm terrified of guns. Like, my best friend died unnecessarily because of a gun, because of a gun being shot unnecessarily. He was 20, like, he did not deserve to die. I've been around so many people that were almost shot. I've been at like 3 shootings in my life where I literally could have almost died. Like, I just don't fuck with guns at all, especially like in the hands of kids illegally at parties, like where people are fighting, like where people are fucked up, where people are ignorant. Like, I just don't fuck with it at all. So I'm standing in the backyard trying to figure out how I want to leave, and I'm talking to my friends more, and I'm like, who was the guy? Like, what did he look like? And someone was like, I saw him, I know what he was wearing. And I was like, what was he wearing? And they're like, oh, a blue bandana, which like, can I leave? Like, that's a black shirt, black jeans, and blue shoes. And I'm like, no way, like, you're fucking kidding me. Like, you're really kidding me. Like, no, he wasn't. Like, you're fucking with me. Like, I literally have goosebumps. That's what the guy that was trying to roofie everyone was wearing. And I was like, was he really tall? And they were like, yeah. And I was like, no, no, I have to leave. I have to leave. If this guy has a gun and he can shoot anyone, it's obviously me. Like, I foiled his plan to roofie like 80 bitches. Like, I really have to go. And at that point, I'm freaking the fuck out. Because honestly, like, if that guy could shoot any girl in the party, it wouldn't be all the drunk hoes he tried to roofie to run a train on. And by hoes, I don't mean literal hoes. It's just like my vocabulary, Vegas. He would shoot me. I'm the sober girl who foiled his plan and was rude as fuck to him. I need to leave, okay? So I'm freaking the fuck out. So I finally find a wall to hop, and it's like an 8-foot drop. And I'm like, whatever, I can do it. So I'm trying to figure out how to hop it. Like, it's complicated. So I'm pulling up a chair to go ahead and step on the chair and then hop the wall and then like jump down. And like, it'd be in like the front yard, but on the side. And then I was just gonna run away to the car. And as I'm doing this, this sweet girl, and if you are watching this, dude, I'm so fucking sorry, comes up to me and she's like, I'm a subscriber. Can I please take a picture with you? I watch all your videos. And I'm like, dude, I'm gonna get shot. I'm really afraid of guns. Like, I don't know what the fuck to do. I'm putting the chair over the wall so I can like jump over the chair, and I piss the guy off and he's gonna get mad at me and he's gonna shoot me. Like, what the fuck? I need to go. I'm really afraid of guns. Like, I need to go. Not even kidding. That is exactly what I did to this poor fucking girl. And she looks at me and she's like, I just watched your videos today. Can I have a picture? Like, I didn't even say that to her at all, 100%. Like, she did not react to what I said at all. She just goes, I just watched your videos today. Can I have a picture? And I'm like, sure. And in the picture, I'm literally stepping on a chair to jump over a wall. Like, I'm stepping on a chair. Like, stepping on a chair. In my eyes, it's not even like I was like, I'm so sorry. But I made sure to still thank her for supporting me and ask her for her name. But if you're watching this, thank you so much for supporting me. I really love you and I'm so fucking sorry. So then I realized that I can't hop the wall and I have to walk back through the party, and I'm like running through the party. And like, hella people just got there and they were like trying to say hi to me. They were like my friends. And I was like, no, no, I gotta go. Sorry. And they're like, what the fuck is going on? It was so bad. So I get in the car and I'm driving home. I Snapchat about it. I'll probably put those Snapchats at the end of this video. Like, not a big deal. I didn't think it was gonna be a main channel story time at all if it was over. So then a couple friends call me and they're like, hey, we just left, like, what do we do? And I'm like, well, you guys can come over. Like, I guess I'll have like 10 people over because I'm in the middle of moving. All my stuff is in boxes anyways. I'm just switching lofts, but that's another video. So I have a call box where I live to call into my place to buzz you in. So when people call me off the call box, it's like a guard gate kind of thing. They can talk to me briefly for a second, like on my phone, and I can hear what they have to say. I'm rushing because there's low battery, but I really want to get the story done. So everyone's in my house for like 20 minutes. We're just hanging out. We're talking about what happened. My friend that got pressed with the gun is at my house, like, talking to him about the situation. I think everything's over, whatever. I'm getting calls from my call box all night though to let people up, because every single person that comes into my house has to call first. I'm answering all these calls, talking to people, asking them their names, letting them up, and I get a call on the call box and I'm like, hello? And there's just a long silence and I'm like, hello? Because like, if it was any other call, I would just hang up, but like, I knew it was like a friend, or at least I thought it was a friend, and I was like, hello? And then this guy's voice, it's not a voice of anyone that I'm friends with. And let's say the guy friend of mine that's like my close friend that like the guy held the gun to, let's say his name is John. And so the guy that's talking to me on the call box is like, I know John in there, can I talk to John? And I'm like, no. And I didn't think at first that it was like the guy, like the fucking, I'm gonna roof you and I'm gonna shoot you guy. And I'm like, what's up? Like, what do you need? Like, he's not here. Cause I didn't know who it was and I wasn't gonna like put him on the line there and be like, he's right here. Like, what if it was, you know, something bad? And then I realized that it's the voice of the guy. And I'm like the guy. And I'm like, he's not here. And he's like, I know he in there. Like, don't make me come up there. Like, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, dude, don't come here. He's not here. No one's fucking here. Like, get the fuck out or I'll call the cops. And then it hangs up. And then I made everyone leave because I didn't want to die. So I'm literally, and I said that so much calmer. I was just freaking out for like a half an hour. I was tearing up. I was gonna call the cops, but like, he left. I checked the cameras, but like, I don't know. My doors are locked now. He doesn't know what a like condo number I live in, and like all the buildings are gated as well. So I'm like pretty safe, kind of, but every time I think I'm safe, I almost die. Ah, my stalker, Pastor Lyft driver. So John is fine, by the way. That guy, apparently the roofie drug guy, is really addicted to Xanax. And if you know anything about Xanax, it makes you do really bad things. So that makes sense. Don't ever get addicted to Xanax. I've seen that literally ruin so many people's lives. That's the big sister message of this video, honestly. A, don't drink out of bottles from other people. And B, don't ever take Xanax recreationally if you're not using it for like a medical prescribed reason, because it's very addictive. And I've seen it ruin so many lives. My first love's life, literally my first love's life was ruined by Xanax. But like I said, that's another video. I almost got roofied. I almost got shot. I pissed off someone who literally could have shot me. This is why I don't go out. Vegas parties are like no fucking other. I saved a girl's life from being roofied. Had the weirdest fan encounter of my entire fucking life. And someone literally knows where I live. I don't know if he knows it was my house or not, because the call box doesn't have like my name. It's like a code thing. I don't know. I'm not gonna live a long life if you clearly see why. I hope that if you are young and you're watching this, did learn some form of lesson from this, because that's the goal. And I'm kind of proud of myself, because all my old stories were like, here's a time that I fucked up and did the wrong thing. Like, honestly, 2013 Tana would have drank out of that bottle. So to be able to see myself like mature and wise up throughout my YouTube channel is a really cool thing to share with my literal family, and to help other people not make dumb decisions through my dumb decisions, and to see how I've learned from my own dumb decisions is a really awesome thing. Thank you guys for all of the absolute amazing love lately. You are my family, and I would not be anywhere in the world without you. And I know I say it in every video, but I never feel like I say it enough. So I hope you enjoyed this story. If you did, please subscribe, share it on Twitter, like that shit. Check out all my social media below. My Instagram has been popping lately, 100k likes. Thank you guys so much. And my merch and tour info are below if you want to find those other things as well. So like I said, you are my family. I fucking love you. I would be fucking nowhere without you. This fucking channel is all you. And I will talk to you guys in the next video. Bye.